Morning. Today I wanted to use the bloom technique. So that is the paint mixing. And I am going to use my hairdryer, but I'm going to use it in a different way. And that is something that I saw on Shelly Art's YouTube channel. And I thought I wanted to try it too. I have all kinds of blue and gold and greens that I have mixed up for weeks now. So I really need to finish these jars so I can make some fresh stock. So I will mention the colors when I put them on my canvas so you know. And well, let's have some fun. First, I am going to put down my pillow paint. Which is a house paint. And if you like to know what you exactly need for this technique, at the end of my video, in the last 10 seconds, you will see a little square pop up. And there is a video there where I show you what you need and how to mix your paints. And I found this little hexagon canvas, really cute. And I thought I would try that. I've never poured on a hexagon, but well, we'll see. Okay, let me pop out the air bubbles first. Be really quick because house paint will burn very fast. And that is not something we want. There was something in there. Okay, now I'm just going to lay down my colors first. And well, I have no clue anymore what I did when I practiced this. I put that up on my Facebook channel and people really like that. So I will try to duplicate that, but that will probably not work because a pour is never the same. Well, we all know that. I was just laying down a little bit more of the pillow paint. Okay, this is the peacock feather. And on there. Well, I mixed this as a cell activator, but I will just use that as a color now. And now the sea glass, really pretty color. And I think I will put on a little bit more paint than when I practiced, because I noticed that I had blown away the colors and I ended up with, well, it was very pretty lacing, but it was a black lacing on the white paint. And I would like to see a little bit more color. But, well, this is the Northern Lights. I love that color. Here we have the green tea. A very deep, bright green. Here we have the sapphire on ice. It's really pretty. And I will put some key lime. These are all from Primary Elements. I will put some key lime on my Sapphire on Ice. If you are interested in buying Primary Elements, I know they are not cheap, but below my video you can find a discount code, a coupon code, that will give you a 20% discount. So I think that's a lot. And well, in that way you can save some money. I think they are very worth it because they are gorgeous. These paints are a little bit thickened up because I mixed some of them weeks ago, but that's okay for this technique. Here I have the Douglas Fir. I just love that green of the Douglas Fir. Let's see, and a little bit of the Boysenberry. I'm making a mess here with all that jars. Okay, and now a little bit of the Interference Gold, so we get a really pretty golden shimmer. A little bit of the Interference Blue. Oh no, this is a Sparkle Blue. It's Interference Sparkle Blue. Love that. And a little bit of the Bling It Indian Spice, which is a very pretty shimmery gold. Okay, I will pop out some air bubbles really quick. Go away, bubbles. And on top of that, I'm going to put some white and some black cell activator. If you want to know about the cell activator, at the last 10 seconds of my video, you will see a pop-up. Click that pop-up, that little square, and then you will go to that video. So I'm going to use, it won't come out. Okay. So I'm going to use black and white because I thought that would be funny. And I will probably blow off a lot of the paint because of the shape of the canvas. But we will see. I think I will do a little black line over this white. Okay guys, wish me luck. Because you never know if you can do something once, if you can do it again. So there we go. It looks like the black took over a lot there. We will just wait until the paint comes up again. And then we will try to stretch everything. and see if I can try to keep on ear what I like and to pour off what I don't like. Okay, let me take away the cups a little bit. So I first will try to get rid of a little bit of that black there. Can you see all that shimmer and shining? Okay, well, this looks nothing like I did earlier, but I think it's pretty. I don't know what happened there, but there's a strange, you see that? Maybe I burned it a little bit with my that's so strange. There was a really hard piece in there. Okay. Okay, I think it's pretty, but I will do this one again and try to make it look more like it looked on my Facebook page, because this is pretty, but it does not look like the one on my page. Okay, I will put this back on the cups for you. And I am going to get my camera to give you a close-up. And you know what's really pretty? That gold is floating over that black. Yeah, really pretty. Okay, guys, okay. I'll be back with the close-up. I will show you now the one I did on my Facebook. That's this one. And, well, because I used a lot more colors now, this one doesn't even look close to that. So I will do another one and use less colors. And hope to replicate the first one. But I will show you this now. Really pretty. Oh, wait a minute. I need to change my light to show you the shimmer. Beautiful. Can you see that gold floating on top of that black? Yeah, that's really pretty. It's always so difficult to show that, but really love those primary elements. I thought I would show you the dried results of both paintings. And this is the first one that I did, and I showed this one on my Facebook page, but I did not make a video because this was just a test. But I did the same technique as we did today. And I think it turned out really pretty. I'm trying to show you the bling and the sheen that's in here. And I know that if we will put some resin on this, this will be stunning. Just look at that, it's so pretty. And I just love that lacing right here. I think that's really pretty. Just look at that. Well, I just thought I would show you the dried results of both. But as you can see, there's pretty much white in this one because I used less color. I just want to show you that green there. This is so pretty, I think. But okay, this one has a pretty much white in it because I use less color. And this one, of course, is a very small canvas and I used way more colors, but it's still, I think, very pretty. And I will show you up close. And I will put some resin on them both and show you, but that will be somewhere in the spring or in the summer because it's way too moist now in the Netherlands, at least for me, because my house is very moist, to use resin. So I will all save them and resin them later on this year. But I think these colors that I used are so gorgeous together. So really guys, if you would like some primary elements, and I know they are not cheap, but luckily I have a coupon code that is 20% off, and I think 20% discount is very much. So if you can save up for them or whatever, I would really recommend you try them because this will really change your world and change the way you look at how you do your art. For me, it changed my life. I think it's gorgeous. So these are the two of them. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you liked it, please give me your thumb up, subscribe to my video. Don't forget to enter my celebration for the 50,000 subs, because you can win some of the color art pigments. And okay, I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.